I'm not into Shakespeare's whole creepy mask thing. Reminds me too much of that sex party I went.
Check out the vending machine near the Ultor building. Is it a special vending machine? No. Have you bought stuff from the store already? Probably. But I would be remiss as your guide if I didn't show you the basics.
Better and better.
I will fucking end you.
Maybe I can crush this thing.
The Forge is prime real estate in Hell. This smoggy shithole is located over the richest mineral veins in the afterlife. You want to hurt Hell's infrastructure? Here's where you do it.
I'm not into Shakespeare's whole creepy mask thing. Reminds me too much of that sex party I went to.
It's easy. I gotta get this someplace safe.
My lawyer, Legal Lee, figured out a way to get some gold-level clients a fast track out of Hell. The more abuse you put these guys through, the more years we can shave off.
Lee suggested running clients through the designated intersections to boost their punishment. Oh, and dive in front of those vehicles on fire for bonus points. I mean, let's face it, the more they hurt, the sooner we can get these wretched bastards out of here.
While his wife Laura was admitted into heaven, the Heavenly Father was less forgiving of poor Tobias, whose shirtless antics as a crazed drug dealer firmly earned him a place inside the Great Inferno. However, ever the optimist, Tobias tried to look on the bright side of being transformed into a husk. After all, while the removal of his signature dreadlocks was a disappointment, he was finally free from having to wear pants ever again. But while Perpetual Commando appealed to Tobias, he still yearned for Laura and her delightful snickerdoodles. Touched by his story and terrified by his demeanor, Legal Lee worked with renewed purpose to unite the two lovers.
This feels good. Thank you.
buddy, let's take this opportunity to stretch those wings. I've set up a rudimentary flight path through the city. All you need to do is hit the checkpoints in the order they appear. Now, because I'm a swell guy, I put some orbs out there to help you. The white ones will recharge your wings.
See what these things can do.
Gotta pick it up.
Yeah!
Running out of juice.
God, this feels good.
Okay, I have a thought on how we can get the attention of Satan, and I really think you're gonna like this one. Blow the shit out of everything, and I mean everything! Demons, cars, fences are real popular. Just tear this place apart!
Success.
harder than that, Satan.
Got a touchdown.
All right, it's salvation time. Satan's using his magic to send souls skyward and downward into oblivion. That's where you come in. Catch the falling souls before they hit ground and use an arcane blast to free the souls rising upward. Of course, once you do that, you'll still have to catch them before they drift off to their death. Speed is key here. You'll get a bonus for every soul you can save before touching down. Now let's go save some clients. I mean souls. Poor souls that need help.
Gotta pick it up. Sorry, bad guy. Out of juice. Need the rest of wings. Let's see what these things can do.
Just entered one of four soul extraction facilities. This is where souls enter hell to have their sins removed and then thrown to the streets to wander for eternity. Now make no mistake, this isn't Satan being magnanimous. Sins are the currency in hell. That means these places are the cornerstone of his income. There's three sections of the facility, and to fully take it over, you need to capture all three. But be careful. Satan's goons are going to be looking to reclaim any section you're not guarding. We pull this off, you'll hurt Satan and Ultor makes money. It's win-win.
Thank you.
Winning isn't important.
Great work. Old Tor's moving into the territory you freed up, and we're already seeing a difference. I can't wait to see what happens when we own it all. Men like Blackbeard are the best to work with. You always know what they're looking for.
Touchdown.
Your voices made me do it.
Running out of juice. It seemed like a better idea when people weren't trying to kill me. Ready to give up yet?
Great job tearing up hell.
Thanks. I need you to stop.
What? Do you really think Satan could still be thinking about Jezebel's wedding after all the damage you've done? I'm telling you, the devil is about to react in a weird way.
And when he does, we need to be ready.
Satan didn't have much time to react to the war Gat was waging, because at home, Jezebel was waging a war of her own.
I don't love them!
You think I care?
If you started acting like a father, you would.
I'm looking after your best interest.
You don't care about my happiness! This is about you! If you just stop telling—
You will marry that saint, and I won't hear another word!
I won't do it!
You think because you're my daughter, you think that you're above it all. But schemes are currently in motion. Your choice, be a wife or be a thrall. They say the devil's in the details, and I have some more for you. Celestial light doesn't shine a ray here. Happy endings are through. To me, I'm giving you away. Your blood will not save you. My hand will be cruel if you disobey. You belong to me.
Never. I'm sick of perdition, so tired of tradition. But now my time has come to go break away, to live for today, to stand out beneath the sun. I know there has to be some way for me to be free. Just living a life that's far from the strife and torturous pain. Someplace that's far from here and not awash with. How do I feel about cats? And is Nightblade my new favorite show? But until that time, I'm stuck in this hell, a relentless tempest of rage. Surrounded by guards, betrothed by my father, trapped inside this gilded cage.
It's not working, Kinsey.
You don't know that, Johnny.
I'm tearing this place apart, but Satan doesn't even seem to—
We didn't come this far to fail.
You think I'm giving up?
We have one less place to go.
What if it doesn't work?
The bus is counting on us.
You think I don't know? How do I burn down a city that's baptized in fire? How do I kill off an army that's dead? Time's slipping away now, and the best plan we've got is just put one inside Satan's head. If roles were reversed, God, I know they'd save me. But all my solutions involve murder sprees.
You have to stay the course and kill without remorse.
Yeah, that sounds fun, but what has that done? We're still where we stand.
The day isn't over yet. Our sun's not begun to set. No matter how small, the wings of a fly can create hurricanes. Johnny Gat. Hope. I feel hope. For the first time I've ever in my life. Gat is the name that cuts through my father like a knife. The seed of rebellion, it grows like a weed. And someone so violent is just what I need. There's no turning back now, the die has been cast. This sinner has found her saints, I'll be free at last. The people, the music, it waits up above. I know I'll be happy when I find love. I know I'll be happy when I find
love. Like Satan's noticed that the current disruptions have been caused by everyone's favorite winged terrorist, and he's looking to do something about it. Display spire emplacements all around the city. Now, these things look like slimy tentacles, but make no mistake, they can shoot you out of the sky. The only way we can stop these things is to literally rip out their hearts. And by we, I mean you. I'll be at the office drinking scotch.
God, this feels good.
Thank you.
Got a touchdown.
The Barrens is the perfect staging grounds for all manner of operations against Satan. But first, we have to secure it.
Vlad's a little too intense for my liking. He's that guy.
I got word from Blackbeard that every island has a treasure chest hidden on it. What's in the chest? I don't know. I'm not a fucking pirate. What I...
Blackbeard kinda sucks at hiding these things. These things better not be a bitch to find.
Thanks for helping me deal with the crew.
Of course it's locked. These things can do.
Yeah! this all hell's got to offer?
Gotta find more. Need the rest of wings.
God, this feels good.
Go!
Running out of juice. This is bad timing. Running out of juice.
Shakespeare secretly longed for overt control of the entertainment district. If only someone could act on behalf of the thoughts he kept to himself. The bard had written about love enough times to recognize attraction when he saw it. Dane was smitten by a certain lady, even if the young executive did not know it.